Hi guys, welcome back to Fisholover Issue. I guess for those of you in the industry, you would notice over the past few decades, many innovations have been developed to move towards sustainable aquaculture practice. So today, as you see from the title, you'll discover the innovations in aquaculture that have been developed to reduce carbon footprint and increase the potential of sustainable farming. The conventional mesh net suspended with support from various frameworks such as steel, wood or plastic and held in place by downhaul weight. Over the time, high-density polypipe HDPE were introduced as it is more durable than other framework. However, most of these cages were allocated near the coastal areas where oxygenated water carried by the natural current will bring the accumulated waste fall from the bottom of the ocean to the wild fish. So today, several technologies are available to lessen this problem. Offshore aquaculture have been tremendously helpful and have been promoted to reduce the environmental impact of solid materials such as aquapod system. A geodesic dome cage with semi-closed containment could limit the effect of effluent released into the natural water as they are located far from the coastline with deeper water. Inland aquaculture or recirculation aquaculture system or RAS is also another favorable system to be adopted nowadays as it is clearly separated farm and wild fish from each other. The use of filtration and aeration system within RAS will not only reduce the utilization of water but also keep the fish healthy and less prone to disease as they could be monitored thoroughly. This innovation has made the possibility for aquaculture to capture the interest in urban areas where natural water source is limited. And the evolution of aquaculture feed has long been studied since the World War II. Prior to that, hatchery fish was fed with raw meat, particularly cattle and horse meat. A report showed that in order to produce 4,000 kilos of trout, a whole cattle or horse daily are required to satisfy their nutritional requirement. Pellet feed had only been developed after World War II. The ingredients were fully consist of fish meal and fish oil derived from marine capture fisheries, as protein and lipid source. And currently, few ingredients options are available to reduce the dependency to fish meal and fish oil. Among others are microalgae such as spirulina and chlorella. Microalgae has been observed to contain long-chain omega-3 fatty acids similar to fish oil and equivalent amount of essential amino acid required by the fish. Another current protein source with hugely demand is insect meal, particularly black soldier fly or BSF meal. Raising BSF by using waste for animal feed is not only sustainable but also cost effective and low environmental footprint as they could breed easily within small space. And energy is one of the common issues in many industries, including aquaculture. The energy cost particularly related to operational and maintenance in hatcheries, especially for marine intensive culture, is one of the highlighted issues that commonly associated with inland aquaculture. One of the favorite renewable energy at the moment is solar thermal. With the new advance in solar panel technology, it will be feasible to reduce this cost and meet the power demand, especially in intensive hatchery culture. Besides solar thermal, wind turbine is another renewable energy that have been used in agriculture. Another great contribution of offshore aquaculture is the ability to install wind farm together with offshore culture of mussel and oyster farming. Wind-powered aeration could also be used to reduce the dependency to electrical energy. This innovation has been used in pond culture to aerate the water and increase dissolved oxygen concentration, particularly during the summer months. And for now, that's three important innovations that I could share with you. If you have any other innovations in aquaculture that worth sharing, why not drop by in the comment section below? And if you like this video, please share and give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more updates. Till then, thank you for watching and see you next time.